So the final day of preparations, the Ashes urn came out, although it was only a mock-up, of course, and England prepared to face Australia, and Australia without Brett Lee.
Yeah, I think we've got to be wary of looking at it like that. I mean, Brett Lee's a fantastic bowler, and yeah, it's hard to cover him being out of the side. But I think from our point of view, you've always got to expect an Australian bowling attack to be strong. Whatever way they go, whether someone like Hilfenhaus comes in or whether they play the spinner, there's still going to be a good balance to their attack. So we're expecting a good examination early on. We've got to be good enough to overcome that. And then hopefully we can go on and rest the initiative of the game and get in a good position.
It's 2005 for me and for the rest of the guys in this squad is a long way away. You know, I said yesterday it's almost 50 test matches ago since the 2005 series. So, you know, there's no doubt that there's a lot of hunger around the group. There's a lot of desire around the group to build on things that we felt we started as a group in South Africa. Our level of play over there was exceptionally high and our standards were very high, and we want to maintain those through the next couple of months. And wherever that takes us, it takes us. But, you know, we're really well prepared at the moment. There's a great feeling around the group, and having almost a month to get prepared for one test match is something that's pretty unusual in all of our careers. So right at the moment, the spirits are great, and we're looking forward to tomorrow.
The wicket looks pretty good to me. I think it's going to be a good wicket. They've obviously put a lot of preparation into it, even covering of grass. So we expect it to be a pretty good wicket. There'll be a little bit in it, probably for the seamers early, and then back end, hopefully the spinners will come in as well. So it's there's a little bit in it for everyone, to be fair. Two spinners gives you more balance, doesn't it? Obviously, a left-arm spinner and off-spinner, they can attack the left-handers and right-handers differently. And I suppose, in a way, it allows you a little bit more of a measure of control because you've got more options up your sleeve. So, I mean, it's definitely an option for us, and you know, we'll be looking at that overnight. Probably have a look at the wicket first thing in the morning before announcing the side.
Done yet? No, only finding out yesterday afternoon about Brett's injury and the possibility of him being out for a couple of games. We haven't finalised that yet. As you can see, with the weather the way it is, as well as sort of hindering things a little bit with what our final makeup will be. So hopefully by the end of training today, we might have that done. If not, it'll be certainly obviously announced at the toss in the morning.
To be fair, they've done a great job with the stadium here. I mean, it looks ready to go. The wicket looks good, and I really hope that the Welsh get behind this over 5 days. I mean, I think it's a sellout. I think it should be a great atmosphere in which to play cricket, and if we can play well, hopefully we'll get the crowd right behind us, and that can provide some momentum for us as well.
At the end of the day, I don't think we'll know just how close the sides are until the end of the series. I mean, you can look at stats and bits of paper with names on it, but you just never really know with this game how teams are going to perform at different situations and under pressure. So, you know... Well, all I can say is I know that we're in really good shape and we're looking forward to the challenge and the contest that is ahead of us for the next couple of months. You know, there's been great hype around. There's a lot of excitement around our group. I'm as excited for this series as I've been for any series I've ever played. So that says a lot about where I'm at, and it says a lot about where this current team's at. So I'm just looking forward to getting everything underway. We've done enough talking now, I think, over the last month, and a lot of looking back at different series that have gone in years gone by, but now it's just time to get out there and play.
So then the talking is over. It's England v Australia. It's the npower Ashes, the first test from Cardiff, and it all starts here tomorrow morning. Barney Douglas, ECB TV.